Zach, what are you doing? There you are. What are you doing?
I have to write a report for English class about an exciting experience.
That sounds exciting.
Really, Dad?
I used to be pretty good at reports when I was in school. Let me see what you've got so far. My exciting experience.
Yep, that's all I've got.
I'm sure you have plenty of exciting experiences you can write about.
Dad, this has to be right in front of the class. I have kids here who have traveled to another country or met their favorite professional athlete. My exciting experience will be boring compared to theirs.
Is your assignment to write about your exciting experience or your exciting experience that's more exciting than anyone else in the class?
I know what you're gonna say, Dad. I shouldn't compare my life to others. But it's hard when they brag about their adventures.
Well, you had a pretty unique adventure last weekend.
At Crystal Ridge?
Yes, why don't you write about that?
I can't believe I didn't think about that!
It's definitely an experience I'll never forget.
I can write about the road closed sign that one car ignored and how he kept screaming for him to turn around and come back. But he was too busy acting cool with his friends to even hear us.
The car radio was so loud, he wouldn't have been able to hear us with 100 megaphones.
He was too distracted to see that the road was closed because it had been damaged by weeks of horrible storms.
That crater where the road came apart was deep enough for 5 cars or more.
You were a hero that day, Dad.
I don't know about that. I just jumped into action, made you and my mom get out of the car, and took off after him.
You were flashing your lights, honking your horn, and yelling at them with your head stuck out the window. I was so scared you were going to have to wreck trying to keep them from having one.
They had ignored all the other warnings, so I was desperate.
Then both cars stopped. We couldn't see what was happening. I was terrified, and Mom started praying.
Finally, the driver realized that there was a problem when he saw part of the road was missing. It was almost too late. One tire was hanging in the air while the car looked like it. It could dive into that crater any moment.
Then you jumped out of your car and ran up to help them. I was crying and yelling your name, begging you to get back in your car.
I couldn't leave those people in that car.
Yeah, but they had plenty of warnings. They should have paid more attention.
True, Zach. But there are more people in the car that had no idea what was happening. They were all in trouble and I had to do all I could to help them.
I'm so glad someone called 911. By the time you walked up to their car, a tow truck was on its way to help.
That was a relief to all of us, but I still wasn't sure if we needed to get the people out of the car first before the tow truck hooked up the car. The driver thought it might be safest to coast the car to tip in the crater. Pull them out with the driver and the passengers inside. One person getting out of the car could coast the car to tip in the crater.
I can't imagine how they fell. I would have passed out.
I was so relieved when the tow truck hooked onto that car and got everyone out safely.
That was definitely an exciting experience. I will always remember to pay attention to danger warnings.
There are many warnings God gives us. They might not be road signs or people yelling for you to stop. The Bible gives us instructions on what to do and what not to do to be safe. Many, many years ago, God used prophets to warn the people when they were in danger.
Did they listen?
Some did, but sadly, some didn't. The prophets never gave up trying to warn them.
Just like you didn't give up trying to help that car.
Something like that.
Thanks, Dad. Now I just have to put that all on paper, unless you wanted to do that for me.
Let's try, but you would have a danger of getting in big trouble by your teacher.
Yeah, thanks for the warning.
你在这里呀、啊？你在做什么？
我必须为英语课写一篇关于一个让我兴奋的事情。
听起来很酷。
真的吗，爸爸？
我以前在学校的时候很会写报告，让我看看你写了什么。
哦。
我相信你会有很多好玩的事情可以写。
爸爸，我需要读这个在全班同学面前，有孩子去另一个国家旅行，或遇到很有名的人，与他们相比，我的经历会很无聊。
你的作业是你在写你的经历，还是你在写比别人更激动的经历？
我知道你要说什么，爸爸。我不应该把我的生活和别人比较，但是他们说自己的经历比别的人更好的时候，会很难不跟他们比较。
但上周你有经历了一个非常独特的冒险，
在 Crystal Ridge。
是的，你为什么不写呢？
我没有想到哎。
这绝对是我永远不会忘记的经历。
我可以写一辆车怎么不管交通规则，然后我们不停地尖叫，把他掉头回来，但他和他的朋友装酷，没有听到我们的声音。
那汽车的音乐太大声了，我们用100个黄音剂都不会听，他们都不会听到我们说的声音。
他太分心了，没有看到这条路被关了，因为它被可怕的暴风雪弄坏了。
道路的那个洞可以装5辆车或更多。
那天你是英雄，爸爸。
这个我不知道。我刚开始行动的时候，让你和妈妈下车，跟在她后面。
你在闪灯，按喇叭。把头伸出窗外，对着他们大喊大叫。我很害怕你会为了阻止他们有车祸。
他们没有管其他的警告，所以我就很绝望。
然后两辆车都停了，我们看不到发生了什么。我吓坏了，妈妈开始祷告。
最后即使看到那条路不见了，才发现到有问题，几乎喂食一碗，一个轮胎晃在空中，而这辆车看起来随时都可能掉在那个洞里。
然后你跳下车，跑过去帮助他们。我喊着你的名字，求你回到你的车里。
我不能把那些人留在那个车里耶。
但他们有很多警告。
是的 ，Zach。但车里还有其他的人，不知道发生了什么，他们都遇到了麻烦。我必须尽我所能帮助他们。
我很高兴有人打了911。当你走到他们的车前时，一辆拖车正赶来帮忙。
我们所有人都松了一口气，但是我没有决定我们是否需要在拖车来的时候把车上的人从车里救出来。司机认为把他们拉出来，机师和乘客都在里面是最安全的，一个人下车可能会把汽车翻到洞里。
我无法想象他们的感受，我会昏倒的。
但当拖车 当拖车往那辆车并把所有人安全救出时，我松了一口气。
那是一个让人心动的经历。我会永远记得，注意危险警告。
上帝给了我们很多警告，他们不可能是交通规则，也可能不是大喊大叫让你停下来的人。圣经告诉我们为了安全该做什么和不该做什么。许多许多年前，当人们危险的时候，上帝用先知来警告他们。
他们有听吗？
有些人有，但是有些人没有。但先知没有放弃警告他们，
就像你没有放弃帮助那辆车一样。
对，
谢谢爸爸。现在我只需要把所有这些话写在纸上，除非你要帮我做。
但是老师不会那么开心哦。
是的，谢谢你的提醒。